stupid in everything. I got to get control of this thing. But it's amazing that once you get control of that thing, how far you can go. I want my mind to know who's in charge. My mind was in charge of me, which is why I made all these horrible decisions. Once you take control of your mind, you start making decisions for yourself, which is your mind making decisions for you. Now think about all these different obstacles that may come up. So basically, a lot of us aren't prepared for life. We get up willy-nilly and this whole life is gonna happen. It is gonna happen. But it's gonna happen with a prepared mind or an unprepared mind. Most people attack life with an unprepared mind. What I do is I try to account for all things that could happen, might happen, probably will happen, and then the unknowns. I know for a fact I'm not going to want to work out tomorrow. Therefore, I'm preparing my mind for that. I don't want to do that. I know tomorrow will come with some difficult decisions to make. It may come with getting a phone call saying someone died. This happened, that happened. Be ready for life. Don't let life just start attacking you left and right. Make sure that you start to build a mental armor so that you're ready for life. And that comes in a very physical way, and the physical helps out the mental. With some of us, I had zero discipline, zero self-discipline. I have so many learning disabilities, not even funny, so I just sit down at the table and spend so much time in this, reading and writing and learning, and that kind of translated over to my self-discipline with working out. Everything about it is self-discipline. Everything about it is no one's going to save you. No one's going to come out of the woods and say, hey, I got your back, man. So the only person coming to save you is yourself. Don't look around the corner hoping on a selfish couch about the miracle. It might come to that 1%, but they come in multiples. So you better start getting work. What I'm doing now, there's not enough fuel in my past. And once you sort it out, that flame goes out. It is a very, very powerful thing, but it can't overcome everything. I was angry once I was able to uncover the rug and look at all these different shells that I collected over the years. Because what happens is when you start to collect all these shells, and these shells are bad things in your life, and you put them in your nice treasure chest and you hide them. It reminds you of where you're at, but you don't want to visit them all the time. It was a tough way to go. But now looking back on it, man, I don't have any more shells. Now what's your passion? So now my passion is still trying to find out what is left. What is more? Is it, can I be driven at the end? And I can be. I have only dissected 44 years of my life. While I'm still living, I'm still in my live autopsy. You know, right now, until I'm dead, I'm still examining human potential. How far can the mind go? How far can we go? He's crazy. I'm crazy. They put a title on us, it allows you to go away in your comfort zone saying, he's just nuts. He's special. Special person. That gives you a get out of jail free card. You go ahead and be normal now. But we're special people. No. We found what we want in life. That's all it is. That's all it is. And very few people, they're all confused. Life's confusing if they make it confusing. Jealousy, 100%. You have to, if you're jealous about anything, that is a horrible thing. Back in the day when you're insecure. So all this stuff comes from conquering yourself. Once you feel good about yourself, all the anger, jealousy,
yes,
these things start to really go away. She's like, no, I'm good.
Bones were just hurting so bad, my body's broken. And I wanted to get on that also. And I tried to swim a lot. I wasn't a great swimmer, but putting fins on kind of equalized my body. I wasn't so negative buoyant. So I started fitting a whole bunch. And I spent hours in the pool. I was so scared of the water that I had to live in the water.
Yes.
I had to become one with the water. So going to the pool used to scare me.
Yes,
I went to the pool
awful.
And then
yes,
the bike got easier. I was able to run more.
Oh,
I went
yes,
from like 1 mile. 1 mile was a great accomplishment. 2 miles,
20,
and then from 2 to 3 was a big deal. I went from 3 to 6.
That's
and
it!
That was my goal. And so I just kept, I failed, I go back to scratch. I used some positive motivation, but I started realizing this is part of the process.
What?
This is part of the journey.
So,
I had to realize this is part of my process. Versus just saying, like I used to, I'm just not
yes,
good enough.
Yes, Lord!
If I'm not good enough, we always say that. I'm just not good enough. And then we try something else.
Oh,
I don't
yes,
know if I make myself good enough. And that
oh,
became my mentality.
Gosh,
I want to make myself good enough.
Yeah.
And so I misunderstood a lot, but that's all it came down to. I made myself good enough.
You have an obligation, not to yourself, but to everybody out there that is touched by what you do as a human being.
Yes,
while nobody knows what I'm doing,
my
I am approaching
the
trainer mentally. Because there's a lot of people out there saying that David Goggins is getting after. And if I wake up one morning and don't do that, I go back to that David Goggins who lied about being who he wanted to be. My...
Oh, Lord. This is it.
Woo!